So in this experiment, we're going to work out the formula of magnesium oxide. We're going to take some magnesium and we're going to roast it in air to form magnesium oxide. And then by taking the mass of the magnesium to start with and the magnesium oxide that we form, we'll be able to calculate the formula of magnesium oxide. Okay. So the first thing I'm going to do, I'm going to heat it inside these bottle tops held together by nichrome wire. So I'm going to take the mass of the two bottle tops I'm using and the nichrome wire, and that is a mass of 5.196 grams. So I'll take a note of that. And now I've got approximately 15 centimetres length of magnesium ribbon that I've wrapped into a tight circle. Okay, and I'm going to take that and put it inside my bottle top. Okay, and I'm going to wrap the nichrome wire around the bottle top to hold them closed together. Okay, so I can get them there, wrap them around, and that should hold the bottle tops tightly closed. So I'm going to weigh the magnesium ribbon that is now inside the two bottle tops held together by the nichrome wire, and that is 5.868 grams. Okay. So now we're going to heat this. Okay, this is acting as a little crucible. We're going to heat this with a Bunsen flame, full open air hole, blue flame, for approximately 5 minutes. Okay, so if we turn on the Bunsen like that, and then we're putting it onto a blue flame, and we'll heat it for approximately 5 minutes. And we should see the magnesium light as it reacts with the oxygen in the air. We'll possibly see the glow through the bottle tops. It probably will go bright at some point as the magnesium catches fire. So we'll now turn the Bunsen burner off, and we'll allow that to cool for a few minutes. If we now transfer the bottle tops and re-weigh them. So the mass is now 6.332 grams. So as you can see, we've had an increase in mass. When we started the experiment, we had 5.868 grams of magnesium, and once it's reacted with the oxygen in the air, we have an increase in mass, and it's now 6.332 grams.